Hello, everybody, and good morning. Saigan Cat here with our first full day of Dragon Quest VII. And just like that, the dog starts whining at me. Kona, go lay down. So, what we're up to today, what did we do yesterday? We talked to the old man. So we need to go find Kiefer. Ah, it's you, Saigan. Now I'm not sure what your take on all this is, but I just can't work out what Prince Kiefer's up to. I saw him looking really fed up. Then he suddenly shouted, "Hold on! Who said it had to be a precious object?" You should have seen the way his eyes lit up. I never know what that boy's going to do next. Yo, Suchna, Mary, Truth, Ashes, everybody who's in chat. I'm sorry, I was still in host mode earlier. Prince Kiefer's got ants in his pants today. He's been back and forth like a yo-yo since first thing this morning. Looks like he just got back, though. You'll probably find him up in his bedchamber. I'm not gonna loot everything. I'm gonna miss stuff. Please no backseat gaming today. I want to play the game and enjoy it. Thank you. Alright, Saigan, I'm absolutely shattered, you know? I've lost track of the number of times I've been back and forth between the castle and the old ruins today. I've been down to that statue with absolutely everything I could think of that has anything to do with the sun. And I had to be quick, too. If my dad works out what I'm up to, we're finished. You know, I even gave this funny stone of your Uncle Pike's a try. I asked him to lend it to me, but he said he wanted 5,000 coins for it. I told him to get stuffed, of course. Anyway, I know how he likes an afternoon nap after he's sunk a few at the inn, so I snuck into his place and, borrowed it instead. Actually, I was wondering if you'd mind giving it back to him. Here you go. It's such a big game, guys. I'm gonna miss stuff on my first playthrough, you know? It's been quite a day, eh? But I'm still no closer to finding out what the light of the sun means. No, Mary, I never finished VII. I got as far as Dharma Temple. Which is not far. Anyway, enough about me. How's your day been? Eh? You gave that book of mine to some weird old man? Oh, hold on. That's right, I asked you to. Sorry, what with all the running around this place, the morning... the place. I completely forgot. I was doing such a good job reading yesterday, and I think it's because I had whiskey, and I have not had any whiskey yet today. Are we closer to the truth? Yes! We are! What's that? It's going to take him a while to decipher it? Gah! Doesn't he realize we're in a hurry? Okay, let's go and see the old coot. I'll make sure he understands how urgent this is. I don't know if Dharma would be the halfway point. It was only 20 to 30 hours into the game on the PS version, which is longer than this one, apparently. Merrowing. I'm going to be running this kind of like a marathon, I think, where I'll be taking hourly breaks. And I should be playing for the next 4 or 5 hours, and then some more tonight. But in 4 or 5 hours, I'm going to have to go and pick up the kids. But this will all be going up on YouTube as well, for those who were not able to make the stream. Punching barrels that I already punched. Oh, back are you? About time. I've just finished deciphering those runes for you. Really? You're finished? So, come on. What does it say? Don't keep us waiting. Who are you? And why are you nagging at me like a spoiled child? Oh, I should have known. It's our beloved prince. Never mind all that. Just tell us what it says. Come on, come on. All right, keep your hair on. If you'll shut up for a minute, I'll tell you what I found out. Now, as far as I can tell, the bright light in this picture at the front doesn't have anything to do with the sun at all. You're kidding, nothing at all? Not even a little bit? Not even the tiniest little smidgen. The light in the picture represents the strength and radiance given off by the pure heart of a chosen one. A what? Chosen by who? And for what? Well, my guess would be by whoever built that temple in the first place. Okay, well, I'm not sure I completely follow you, but if it's a pure heart and some serious strength you're after, look no further. The slow head turned. Oh, so you think you're the chosen one, do you? Can't say I'm entirely surprised. All right then, Mr. Special, here's what the book says you have to do. When purest heart and firm resolve are proved beyond a doubt, seek not your path, O chosen one, for it shall seek you out. Gotcha. So when the chosen one, which is obviously me, shows that statue what a pure heart and true spirit he has, well, that'll do the trick. Ho-ho, you certainly have a high opinion of yourself, but I suppose that can't hurt. Who knows, that unshakable self-belief of yours may set something in motion and reveal the secret of the forbidden place, after all, I must call it a palace. You bet it will. Those ruins won't know what hit them. Don't go punching ruins. It's over here. More books. Intimidatingly thick books. I like Kiefer also. I never had an issue with him. Maribel's the one who kind of annoys me. I liked her a lot more in Heroes 2 though. And I never finished this, so I don't know, maybe she gets better. I'm not into the tsundere type, you know? She's just a brat. There you are, Your Highness. We've been looking for you everywhere. Your father wants to see you. You're going to have to come with us now. You what? What does he want now? If he's just going to give me another earful, I'm afraid I'll have to pass. Your Highness, please. Your father is, not in the most forgiving of moods today. You can say that again. The king will have our guts for garters if we go back without you. I'm begging you, Prince Kiefer. I've got an aging mother to look after. Yeah, and my wife just had a baby. Or was it two? Basically, if we lose our jobs, we're stuffed. Ah, okay, enough of the sob stories, I get it. See, Kiefer is totally likable from the get-go. Saigan, you should head home. I'll come and get you when I'm done. And with that, the sun sets on another long and eventful day. Psst, Saigan, wake up! Come on, wake up, will you? How long have you been watching me sleep, man? Good, I thought you'd never drag your lazy bones out of bed. Sorry it's late and everything, but that took ages. My dad insisted on giving me the ear bashing of the century, and then when he'd finished, he sent me to my room. Can you believe that? What am I, six? Anyway, seems like he was really ticked off about me borrowing that ring. Honestly, I think he's getting sentimental in his old age. Well, he'll get over it. Come on, we need to get going before the sun comes up. Did I check the bags? Nothing in them. Sneaky, 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 sneaky. Where is... I'm actually curious. Is there a walking speed in this? There is! You can actually just regularly walk if you use the analog pad. The circle pad? I don't know what the hell they call it. I keep waiting for Mirabelle to jump out and bother us. Finally, it's time to learn the secrets of the ruins. Let's get moving, Saigan. Prince Kiefer and Saigan hurry over to the ancient ruins under the cover of darkness. Here we are, Saigan. Okay, let's do this. Are you all set?
Yes.
Glad to hear it. Now let's do this. I always knew these ruins were the key to this whole thing. I don't know what's waiting up ahead, but I'm ready for it, and nothing's going to stop me. I'm going to need your help, though. So what do you say, Saigan? Are you with me or what? That's the spirit. Now, the old hermit told us the way forward would only open for people with pure hearts. Well, hearts don't come any purer than ours, right? Hello, here we are. Yoo-hoo! Please reveal the way forward. Whenever you're ready. What's up, fish food? Good morning. Woohoo! We finally opened the door, and all it took was a little bit of self-belief and some shouting. We did it, Saigan. We actually did it. Whoa, this is so exciting. I can't wait to see what's in there. Come on, the real adventure is about to begin. I wonder if this place is as long as it used to be. This used to be such a long dungeon. What is this place? What's that? Over there, floating in front of that massive door. Let's go talk to it. Oh my gosh, that's nice. Guys, check out the minimap. I'm pulling it up for you right now. The shards show up on the minimap, and they have a pulsing blue light, so you can't miss them. I think I added a good, 4 hours to my game time last time I tried playing this on the PlayStation, just because I'd missed one somewhere. Well, it seems you can see me, at long last. How long have I waited? How many decades? No, centuries have passed. I lost track so long ago. In case you were wondering, you're in the Shrine of Awakening. Only those who have been chosen by a higher power are permitted to enter. And, well, since you appear to be here, I think we can safely assume you qualify. Congratulations! Now, you'll have noticed that large door behind me. If you want to open it, you're going to need a little help from the four saints here. So why not step on up and have a word with them? Grab a yellow fragment. It's really hard to get it set up well enough so that you can see... 90% of the game happens on the top screen, you know? So I think I'm just going to be pulling up the bottom screen when it's actually important. Like I did just now. Grab another one. Got another fragment. But you guys should have been able to see that, right? Boom! There, you can see some of the bottom screen. I am the first of the great saints. My dominion is the land, the very ground beneath our feet. In ancient times, the surface of our world was molten and ever-changing. It was defenseless. But in time, it came to be plated in the solid armor of the land itself. I am the second of the great saints. I govern the wind that whips through the trees and drives great waves across the oceans. As the aeons pass, the wind can leave deep scars, its razor-edged blade never resting. To guard against its remorseless onslaught, one must hold one of these. To what do I refer? Probably a shield, because there's a picture of a shield behind you. I am the third of the great saints. I rule over the element of fire, the devourer of all things. When I am angered, I erupt with a livid fury that none can contain. To withstand the fires that fall from the heavens, one must keep a cool head and equip this sacred item. A helmet. I am the fourth of the great saints. My dominion is water, the running rivers, and the endless ocean. Water is the source of all life. It can wash away all evil, its torrents acting as an inviolable shield. But what is true strength? Does it lie in anger? Does it lie in love? Only the sacred sword can show the answer. We'll go from the left and head to the right. How much did this cost? This was $40. Door is sealed with a mysterious power. I guess we'll go down these first. Yeah, like as far as, you know, dollars per hour of entertainment, it's a pretty sweet deal. Door is firmly locked. Before the saints will allow you to proceed, you'll need to find their beloved sacred items. Far to the north of here, in the land of Aster, you'll find an ancient door that has been sealed for countless centuries. Well, it's now open for business. Go through it, and you'll find two ancient tomb sites. Search those, and you'll find four gravestones leading underground. Beneath each gravestone lies one of the saints' sacred items. I'd love to go with you, I really would, but I'm afraid the rules don't allow it. Off you go. Bring the saint's special somethings back to me and prove you weren't chosen for nothing. That feels different than the original game. Like, it's been a while, but I don't remember there being multiple dungeons. I just remember one massive one. It's funny, the introductory dungeon in Dragon Quest VII was longer than, like, most dungeons in other Dragon Quest games. That's how big the original game was. Camera. There we go. I don't know why I'm insisting on using the D-pad. Like, I have a perfectly functional circle pad here, and I'm refusing to use it. Good morning, Mizu. Kiefer, you want to go get the other one? Have to be same time thing? No, apparently not. Boy, that was simple. Hope all the puzzles aren't this easy. Well, look, the Saint's armor. Man, they streamlined the crap out of this opening. It's like they took out an entire dungeon. I understand why they did it, but it was something that I actually really liked. The Saint's Helm. Kiefer requires the Saint's Helm. Why did Kiefer get the armor? Well, we're buddies, but I'm kind of like his sidekick at this point, you know? Tate, why are you so bad at being a cat? Go away. Go away. Go away. Get out of my face, stupid cat. Go elsewhere. Yeah, it did turn a lot of people off. There was a lot of wandering in the original game. Even once you were, like, rushing through it, it still took you, like, an hour to do it. And your first time, it would take 3 hours before you even saw combat. And, you know, that's good for a lot of us, but it certainly didn't help sales in the U.S. It wasn't as direct as what you were supposed to do either. I mean, I can't recall the amount of times I wandered back and forth from the ruins to the castle trying to figure out what Kiefer was getting me to do. There was also the whole thing with your uncle and... What luck, the Saint's Shield. Yeah, it was a very, very late release for the PS1, one of the last RPG releases for the PS1. It was competing with the PS2, it was released after Final Fantasy IX, and it looked like a Super Nintendo game. I remember they advertised it, though, and it still didn't help it. But I'm thinking this re-release, and with the recent love for DQ in the West, thanks to Heroes and, you know, all the attention Builders has gotten, this might do really well. DQ9 did fantastic. Maybe I'm just being overly confident. I want to believe that the West is ready for Dragon Quest and will fully embrace it this time, and then Square Enix will stop being so nervous about releasing it here. I think we've been ready for it, honestly. I think that, Squeenix just doesn't understand how to strike when the iron is hot, and they don't understand how to get the iron hot in the first place. Yeah, DQ9 got a lot of advertising, but again, it was being published by Nintendo, so they were the ones who did all the advertising. DQ8 got published here and got a lot of good advertising, and both DQ8 and 9 did very, very well sales-wise. They just weren't hitting the numbers that some crazy Square Enix execs thought they needed to. Well, 8 got properly advertised, but I think the reason a lot of people bought 8 was for the FF12 demo. So there's a lot of people who have 8 sitting around and they've never played it, which is just such a freaking tragedy, you know? arguably one of the best games in the series. My personal favorite. Ho-ho, splendid! You found all the sacred items. Now all you have to do is return them to their rightful owners. If you need a little hint as to which saint owns what, just have a chat with the statues, or look at the giant picture on the wall behind them. Hey, you want your armor? Boy, it doesn't even have you pick. They just give them the right one. Yeah, Final Fantasy XII demo came with Dragon Quest VIII. I am the second of the great saints. I govern the wind that whips through the trees and drives great waves across the oceans. We've already talked to you. Take your shield, bro. The only reason we got the DQ7 remake was because the French had a huge petition to get this translated and brought to the West. So the difference between the French petition versus our petition that we did in the US was the petition here that got most attention was on change.org, which has been shown to change nothing. What the French did, and I think that we'll have to do this the next time we petition for Dragon Quest, they actually sent in physical letters. Like, handwritten physical letters asking for the game, and that's really what got a lot of the movement done. So next time it's time to fight for a Dragon Quest release in the West, we need to just hunt down the right addresses and start sending them letters. Maybe not full yandere. We don't want to show up at their offices demanding it, but, you know, some letters explaining our love for the series would probably go over well. Ho-ho, how long have I waited for this? How many decades? No, centuries have passed. I lost track so long ago. I've waited so very patiently for the Chosen Ones to come and finally open this door. Thanks to you, I can finally earn my forgiveness from on high and get out of this place. And the dog is barking again. Whoa, where are we? This isn't even like a proper dungeon anymore. This place used to be 10 times this size and filled with all sorts of puzzles. You are in the assembly room. Only the chosen may enter this sacred place. What's the news on the DQ8 remake? Is that getting a Western release? Yes, that's coming out next year. That was already confirmed. It was supposed to come out this year, and they decided to push it out. What was that? Did you say something, Saigan? No. That wasn't you? Well, who was it then? Should you be in need of guidance, speak to the spirit here present. Your path will be revealed. What the? I'm hearing voices. Anyway, I think we're supposed to talk to some spirit or something. Suppose that means our floaty friend over there. Well, come on, Saigan. Let's see what old matey has to say for himself. Hello there and welcome. The assembly room is open for business again at last. As you may have guessed, I'm in charge around here, and if you're wondering how I got the job, let's just say I was chosen by a higher power. I know I don't look a day over 21, but I must be getting on 300 now. Or was it 500? Anyway, age is just a number, right? And besides, we have more important things to be thinking about. Let's turn our attention to the giant four pillars down there beneath us, shall we? Are there even any DQ games left to bring over, excluding Dragon Quest X, which isn't happening, and 11, which isn't even out yet? There's the side games, there's Heroes 2, we haven't gotten a Monsters game since Joker 2. Look a little closer and you'll see that there are mysterious pedestals arranged on top of each pillar. Now, if you happen to come across any fragments of stone tablets on your travels, bring them to me. Each fragment should fit snugly into one of these pedestals, but don't worry about the details. I'll help you with all that when the time comes. So kind! With all the hand-holding! Do we have to go down and around? Because that's the feeling I'm getting. Where's the yellow door? Because we have yellow ones. I thought we were good to go, man. I thought we were good to go. Oh, okay, there we go. Select pillars. We are carrying yellow slabs. We're missing one. No, you still place them. And you get to rotate them still. That's not completely super streamlined. So we still need another... Let's ask for guidance. Is here also our fortune teller for the game? I'm getting something from on high. Here it comes. Yes, I see. Well now, I'm reliably informed that there's another tablet out there just waiting for you to find it. Look for a big ship that's just come home to port, and you're sure to find it somewhere nearby. Good luck out there. Yep, that is correct. Blimey, it's so bright. I can't believe the sun's up already. I better get back to the castle. I'll have a hunt for some of those stone tablet thingies our new friend was talking about when I get the chance. I'm not sure I'll have much luck, though. I searched the place from top to bottom yesterday, and I didn't see anything like that. Oh, and your dad and his crew must be due back from the fishing trip, right? You'd better head back to Pilchard Bay. We don't want anyone to get suspicious. If you find anything, come and get me straight away, okay? See you later. You apparently were not talking to our spirit friend who said, go to the boat. I'm with you, Truth. I'm preferring the original intro. But I do love the updated graphics and music with this game. And I think that it'll be better for the series as a whole. I think it's a good idea of them to take what's recognized as the longest and hardest Dragon Quest and streamline it a bit for modern audiences. This is a good thing for the series. Oh, FF7? Dude, I'm totally expecting the new release of FF7 to be superior. But you guys know my feelings on FF7. One day I'm gonna take the helm, you see if I don't? Some of my landlubber friends ask me if I ever get bored out at sea, but they don't have a clue. The sea's never the same. One day it's angry, the next it's laughing, then before you know it, it's sad. No, I never get tired of spending time out on the waves. Welcome back, Ashes. I know people hate having, like, their games, their, you know, favorite classic games remade, but there's a lot of them that could definitely use it. Like, I've brought it up before, remake the Roto Trilogy with the modern graphics, like, make it look like this, or even like 8. That'd be great. I'm fairly certain... I no longer believe that the slab is actually on the ship. I think I need to talk to people, and somebody probably fished it up or something. Tate. God damn it, cat! Sorry, everybody. Tate kept running around on my desk, knocking shit over. So professional, I know. I've never heard of anyone not wanting remakes of their favorite games. Are you sure that's not just you? Dude, I'm very serious. There's lots of people pissed off when their games get remade. I mean, you're not happy with the changes they're doing with FF7. Humph, you've got nerve showing your face around here, Saigan. Seeing the fishermen back in town reminds me of how you ruined everything. I should have gone with them if it wasn't for you. Could have gone with them. Gah! Why do I have to be the mayor's daughter? Why can't I be a swashbuckling sailor? Don't blame me. Young Maribel is a real handful. Her poor mother is beside herself with worry. She's such a beautiful girl, but she's anything but ladylike. Perhaps I shouldn't be sharing this with you. Keep that under your hat, won't you? Doesn't have to be ladylike. Maybe that's why Maribel's such a jerk. She's trapped in a lifestyle that she doesn't want. Should I go back home? Maybe my dad's there. That's right, Kiefer told me to go home. I should pay better attention. They actually give us much more direction in this game than they did before. Welcome back, my lad. Or maybe it's you that should be welcoming me. Grahaha. I could tell from the tides that this was going to be a good year, but I never imagined it would go so well. We haven't had a haul like that for years. Not since the year you were born, in fact. Actually, now that I think about it, that year was the best of them all. Even this year's harvest didn't come close. I remember coming home all set to boast about how many pilchards we'd netted, but then I found you waiting for me. You really stole my thunder. You didn't hang about, did you? Couldn't wait to get out into the world. I said hello when you started bawling, and then I... Sorry, son. I'm getting a bit choked up. Let's talk about fish, shall we? We caught a lot of fish. A boatload. And more. And tonight, I'm going to sleep like a log. This is the life, I tell you. Back in the bosom of my family after a hard day's fishing. What's that, my lad? You're after something? A nice strong glass of anchovy cordial, maybe? Huh? Did you find something strange while we were out at sea? Well, now that you mention it, yes, we did, in fact. A very strange little object got tangled up in the nets. Where is it now? Aha! Here we go. It's an old piece of a stone tablet or something. I was thinking I should let someone up at the castle take a look at it. Tell you what, I'm as good as asleep on my feet. Why don't you take care of it for me? You can show it to your pal the prince if you like. Here you go. Don't drop it now. I like the dad in this game, too. You guys think remakes should be true to the original, or would that be pointless if all that's different is better graphics? I think that it would be pointless if all that's different is better graphics. I think that you can do a remake well, and you can do a remake poorly. I think a lot of the changes that they've made to DQ7 so far will help it. I might not like them personally. Does anyone else notice that dude in his bed? That's your uncle. And he's awake. Pike. Well, if it isn't... Saigan, and in his own home, too, for once. Whatever next. Hi, Uncle. I know you helped yourself to my prize possession. Don't give me that innocent look. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? Yes. Well, I'm gonna need it back, if that's all right with you. I don't know. I think some games kind of deserve to have a lot of things changed. Again, I'm looking forward to... They even said they're going to be changing some things in the story of FF7, which is good, because the original story of FF7 was kind of convoluted. Yes, the fishing expedition was a big success. Okay, let's go see the prince. We've got the tablet! Maribel's gonna get us. Get out of town before Maribel finds out. No, of course not. Change isn't always good, but it can be. Interesting developments? Hang on a minute, what's that you've got there? It's a bit of a stone tablet, isn't it? Are you serious? It got caught in the net when they were out fishing? Ridiculous. What are the chances of that? Do you know what this is? It's destiny at work. Come on, Saigan, let's go and see old Floaty Face over at the shrine. Personally, open to change as long as it benefits the game and not just there for the sake of it. That's exactly right, Fishwood. And FF7 could do with a graphical overhaul and some clarification on some points in the story. Bring it more in line with the story that they thought had happened in, like, Advent Children. Of course, what benefits the game is largely debatable, but I feel like it'd have a very strong and convincing debate about how convoluted the story in FF7 is. And the game could be definitely improved upon in large ways, and I'm thinking that the new remake, as heavy as a remake as it's going to be, is going to be good for it. I don't know, Mary. I hear really good things about Crisis Core. And I wouldn't mind having more information about Zack in FF7. One of the reasons that I feel FF7 is so flawed is because it took so many other games to fully explain everything that had happened. You know? A solid RPG should be good and understandable in its own right. That other extra media should be extra. It shouldn't be important story points like, you know, Zack's life. Aha, caught you. I knew you'd been sniffing around out here. Did you really think you could keep it a secret? Oh, now she found us. Kiefer, I'll distract her. You run. Maribel. You're a really horrible person. Did you know that, Saigan? You've been doing all this fun stuff and you didn't say a word to me about it. Because you're kind of a bitch. Tate... Go away. You owe me. You owe me big time. So I'm joining you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Got that? She's in one of those moods, Kiefer. I think we should just do what she says. Am I including CC and DC and the phone games? I'm definitely including Crisis Core. As well as... Shoot, I can't remember what it was called. There was that OVA that came with Advent Children on Blu-ray that was really well animated, and it's the events leading up to Zack's fight with Sephiroth at the old reactor in Nibelheim? Good, I should think so too. Now, what are we hanging out about for? Hanging about for? Let's get going. I'm having fun already. We'll just have to lump it, I suppose. She'll only tell on us otherwise. Let's get going. Like, I understand Maribel, but I don't like Maribel that much. Pillars. Yellow. Are we ready? Are we ready to embark on our adventure? Oops. Yeah, just like that. Let her tell on you. We can get shit done before the adults can do anything. She just wants to get out of the house. I mean, let's be fair. She just wants to get out of the house and go on adventures with the boys. There's nothing wrong with that. She just doesn't need to be a bitch about it. What's that? Why is it so bright? Eek! Aye! Arus is just like stalwart standing there. No emotion on his face. Blimey, what just happened? Are you two okay? Of course I'm not okay. I want an explanation for what just happened, and I want it now! Well, all I know is that one minute we were in the shrine, and the next, well, we were here. Where is here, anyway? I don't recognize it. Is it even on the island? What are you talking about? Of course it's on the island. Where else would it be, you big dummy? What I want to know is why the sky is so dark and gloomy. It's not really helping the mood. Gah! Wherever this place is, I hate it already. In fact, I've had enough. I'm going home. Thanks for the amazing adventure. Let's never do it again. Boy, you are just all over the place, Maribel. One minute, I want to hang out. I want to go on adventures. Boo, that adventure sucked. I'm going home. I suppose we should get going, too. We can't hang around here all day. Come on, Saigan. Have I been testing out party chat at all? Accidentally, but it's never been when I had somebody in the party. Where in the world are we? Any ideas, Saigan? There's some party chat. So your guess is as good as mine, eh? It's that sky that bothers me. Why is it so dark? Anyway, we need to get out of this forest. Come on! That sounded an awful lot like Maribel. I suppose we better go and see what's up. Come on, Saigan. Monsters in a monsterless world. Those are good-looking slimes. I love the look on her face. What are those things? Finally, in combat. Yes, it looks good. I'll show you guys what the touchscreen looks like. It's really exactly what you would expect. It's just like the setup on the DS games, actually. I mean, it's prettied up a little bit, but, you know, tactics. Everyone should just show no mercy. There's no reason for us to waste time spamming A to fight slimes. I'm loving the Phantasy Star style combat in this one. Having the characters on the bottom of the screen, it's good stuff. I don't like this one bit. Where exactly are we? And why is it full of monsters? Monsters? You call those monsters? Well, if they weren't monsters, what were they? If they look like monsters and smell like monsters, they're monsters. What does a monster smell like, Mirabel? I'm curious where you're getting this comparison from. Those slimes definitely had way more than 7 HP. You guys are right. Well, anyway, the one thing I know is that this is all you two's fault. I didn't want to come to any stupid forest, but you made me! Well, that's incorrect, Mirabel. You... Stop. She's so tsundere. It's time you took responsibility for your actions, Saigan. You need to make sure I get home safely. Monsters, eh? Kiefer's just happy. Like, we have monsters to fight. Did you hear that, Saigan? Real-life monsters! We're on a proper adventure at last. It wasn't exciting until our lives were in danger. Is it just me, or is this kind of exciting? I know Kiefer! I understand Kiefer. Yes, it is just you. You're such an idiot. Trust you to be happy about this. Listen, I'm not staying here a moment longer. Take me home. Now. Over an hour until your first battle? That's Persona 4 levels of slow openings. Fish food. This was 3 times faster than it was in the original. The original release of the game was, on average, 3 to 4 hours before seeing your first battle. Yeah, depending on how good you were with puzzles. There were a lot of puzzles in there. The one with the branching paths had me confused for a bit, myself. There was also the one where you had to raise and lower the water, there were a bunch of block puzzles. Like, it was a huge, huge dungeon. It felt like a Tomb Raider level. And what are yourselves doing here? Sorry, we weren't sneaking up on you or anything. You've got nothing to fear from us. I'm Kiefer, Prince of Estard. Estard, you say? Could this mean... well, anyway, this is Saigan and this is Mirabel. They're with me. Can you ask Miss Hay what's her name? Why it's so dark and gloomy here? Alright, you'll be wanting to know me name, I suppose. Well, I'm Maeve. Hello, Maeve. Can I ask why you're bothering to weed such a scrawny old patch of grass? Weedin'? Sure I wasn't weedin'. I was putting some nice plants on them graves over there, like. Plants? You mean those handfuls of grass? Why would anyone put grass on a grave? In case you've not noticed, there's not a lot in the way of flowers around here. That's why I've to make do with that little lot, like. Wait, I've got some flowers. Well, some seeds at least. Seeds, you say? Yes, I got them from the woods near Estard. I was going to plant them around my house. I hate to be a bother, but I'd be grateful if ye could see your way to letting me have a handful. Oh, I don't mind at all. In fact, have the lot. Yo-yo or bow? Sure, that's grand altogether. I'll plant these around the graves, so I will. Yeah, fish food. It was, Dragon Quest VII is a marvelous, marvelous game for people who are already Dragon Quest fans. But if you're new to the series, the first PlayStation game is a terrible starting spot, unless you're really into old-school RPGs. Maybe now the souls of the departed can rest a wee bit easier. The departed? Gosh. Maribel just now realizing that those were graves. Now, where are yourselves heading to, if you don't mind me asking? That's a good question. I suppose we're heading home. You just want to go home, do you? Well, I wouldn't start from here, so I wouldn't. Your best bet for now is to get out of this forest. You'll find a little village up the way where you can rest up. By way of thanks for them seeds, I'll come along with you. Temporary party member! Well, let's be off, shall we? To get to the village, we'll need to head out of the forest and go east.
Eggplants!
Some Wobergines. Do we start off with any spells? Nothing. Didn't think so. It'd be weird if we did. Yep. Nothing. Nothing. And in proper DQ fashion, we don't have access to anything that's in the bag. I'm not really surprised. I just wanted to see if there was a change there. My lord, Maeve! She's not screwing around. Hey, Brodiger, how are you doing? I think aubergines are the genus of eggplants? Might be the species? It's the fancy name. It's just a fancy name is all. Let's get to town. Let's save up. I need to take a short break. Wait a second, Saigan. Where'd Maeve get to? I can't see her anywhere. You're right, she's gone. Maybe she rushed off home? I'm guessing she lives here, right? Without even saying goodbye? Humph. Some people have no manners. What kind of village has she led us to, anyway? It looks a little run down. A little? That's the understatement of the century. Well, who cares? It's not like we're going to be staying here long. Let's see if anyone can tell us the way home, shall we? I like that they still haven't figured it out. This was a beautiful big church. You wouldn't credit it now, would you? Well, in times of trouble, what choice do we have but to turn to the Almighty? Save. Alright. Another hour into the game. We've finally seen combat. We have battled monsters. Now the game has truly begun. I'm your host, Saigan. I will be taking a short break for those of you on Twitch. For those of you on YouTube, check out the next episode tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everybody. Check out my Patreon.